Welcome back to Gran Jacamito and the Pedroche Valley of Andalusia, Spain, where we have figured out how to do things on our own. I believe Mama Dog Miriam agrees. There is still some more work to do on our generators, and so the journey with that continues. When this one came back from the shop where we brought it for maintenance, the exhaust wasn't mounted properly. And so, after a little while, it got extremely dirty on the inside. And now Ansel started to clean it up. These generators have a lot of screws, and it takes a while to get them all out, and then, when putting it back together, screw them all in. It's because the thing vibrates so much that it requires a lot of screws to hold everything in place. You can see the burn mark on the diesel tank. That's pretty bad. The round thing at the bottom with all the cables is the alternator. That is the thing that actually produces electricity. And in there is also a lot of the exhaust gases and of course all the particles. And now Angel is trying to clean this, because without that there is no electricity. Good morning. We have had a whole week of rain, some good downpours and a lot of dribble, and I'm here looking at our paddock A18, which according to our time tracking is way overdue for grazing. But let's have a look at how the reality really looks like. While it was raining, this was already a little bit higher, and it came to the point of overflowing. This is in the middle of our land. This is the seasonal creek that leads to the pond. The pond is there around the corner, and this is the ford where our driveway crosses. As you can see, the water level, or the water stops there in the middle of this part, and further ahead right here in front of me it is moist, but we don't have really standing water here. This can fill up, but apparently it needs a lot more rain than we have gotten. So if I pan over here, there is some forage, but it's not really good for a longer time because there was no sunshine. So water is good, but a week of only water and no sunshine is not perfect. But what we do have, you can see this here, we do have clover that comes up, and there's a lot of it. Well, this is all a very positive thing. And here where the road used to be, this is also being conquered by the plants. So the road is disappearing now. And adjacent to it is our best paddock, A15. There is this patch in the center where the grass is always greener than elsewhere. But the other parts are also coming up nicely. So it is also improving here. And I believe with the sun that is now coming out, this will now develop very quickly. I will now have a look at that part of the seasonal creek, and I'll show you in a second. here there is no standing water. It has not been enough. And if I zoom in here into that hole, that is where the seasonal creek crosses over from the neighbor's land to us. You can see it is only stones there and not much is happening. It is the neighbor always has the sheep out and they will of course eat everything that wants to go. So this is not our land there. We only have a small part of the seasonal creek, the lowest and shortest part of it. Someone had an idea to build more structures to hold the water. There isn't much opportunity to do this because this here, and turning around, that is all that is. And this is the end of it. And we have already created all the structures that were possible. So here in this part of this creek, there's nothing else that I can see we might be doing. But as I mentioned before, left and right of this, we will have a lot of vetiver, so that we have more vetiver to plant elsewhere. And of course, will also help the surrounding areas. And of course, we have to fence off that creek with the vetiver once we have it planted. But we will see that later in spring. These images are before grazing. The plan is to bring the cows here tomorrow. While we had a lot of rain, there was no sunshine, and because of lack of sunshine, the energizer stopped working, and the cows challenged this part of the fence because on the other side there was something greenish looking. And so now, this morning, the guys have to repair this little damage. It's not that bad, but of course they ventured in there and tried to take advantage of the new growth. But it's not a big problem, it's just part of work in progress. And here they are, unhappy and mooing, because they are stuck in this lane here, because the guys closed the door so that they can fix the damage. But then they also saw the blue cow, and they want more of the alfalfa pellets. They were on their way to drink water further down, but now they saw me and decided otherwise. They also managed to topple this fence post because it was not sufficiently deep into the ground. And the reason for that is that the ground was so hard that the auger and other means were not able to penetrate deep enough. Now that it has rained a lot, there is an opportunity to make it better.
Ball geben. Schauen wir mal. Vale, vale.
Ahora vamos a tensar mucho.
Como que se va a ir otra vez, lo vamos a perder. Vale. ¿Puedes? Dame el último ahora, Juan.
¿El lavado?
Sí.
Soon we will be able to graze here. Couple of days of real sunshine and this should then be ready for grazing.
That was it for today. In a couple of days I share a little bit more information about some of the challenges that we are facing currently. Till then, take care and see you soon. Bye bye.